So this is the morning of day four. There's still clouds in the sky. I checked the weather prediction for this afternoon, and unfortunately it doesn't look as if the wind will be good for our spot, but we'll see what happens. This morning we're going to stalk a bit, just because it's been very slow in the mornings. So I'm just quickly shooting long range. I think we might need it this morning, but look here. This is a 90 yard grouping. That's just a flyer on the last shot. I got a little bit tired and yeah, just pulled it, but I don't think that's too bad. Taking all things in consideration. So yeah, it looks good. I'm very, very happy with this. We'll see what the day holds. Hopefully we can get our first animal on the ground, so stay tuned. It's a bit of a late start, but we went to scout a little bit this morning and I shot in my bow up to 100 yards. So yeah, we're on our way back to our blind. We actually, with the wind, we're going to sit at the original spot. And then we're hoping and praying that our luck will finally change and turn, and then maybe this afternoon we can whack a mountain zebra. So yeah, let's see what happens. It's very, very warm, so in my mind the animals have to come in for a drink. So let's see what happens. I'm positive. Definitely is positive.
Very.
So yeah, stay tuned. I think we said it 3 times already, but today is going to be the day. So let's see what happens. Just did this massive freaking intro, freaking speech, and really it was nice. Even saying so myself, it was freaking nice. And then when I wanted to review it, it didn't record. So, but that's just the icing on the cake. At 4:40, 22:05 in the afternoon, I just saw two big ears coming our way. Immediately knew it was a mountain zebra. Got turkey ready, he started glassing, and the closest one was 174 yards when they stopped. Looked at something and then just buggered off. The wind was good. Basically the only explanation we have is that our secondary blind, it's basically just camo net. A part of it was a little bit flapping in the wind, but not by much. So only thing we could have thought of was that they saw that and they went. So yeah, super disappointed. We're almost 31 hours in the blind. Well, have been setting for 31 hours the past couple of days. And today's conditions are much better than what we thought it would be. The wind is kind of in our favor the whole time. And still, they busted us. So, I don't know. We still have, it's just over, just past five, so we still have like 2.5 hours to make it happen today. Yeah, I really hope we can make it happen. I feel we deserve a mountain zebra at this stage. But yeah, let's see what happens. Wish us luck. So today is the last day at this specific area. We're moving again tomorrow. Yesterday evening was so disappointing with those zebra coming in, and something just bothered them. That Birchall's zebra came in perfectly, and I mean, if that was a mountain zebra, I would have shot him. I actually drew back on him just to make sure that everything was, you know, kind of fine in the blind. So, yeah, after that, a lone water buck bull also came in. But unfortunately, those were, he wasn't on the menu. Last day, last chance to make it happen. Okay, Hartmann's mountain zebra, sorry. I'm just busy shooting here at 82 yards. So, let's see what happens. I'm still positive, even though the hope yesterday was almost gone. But let's see what happens. I think, like the previous days, today will be a good day. So I'm back in the zebra spot. I'm hunting on my own this afternoon. Good friend Ben van Wyk is coming in this afternoon. I'm gonna hunt with him from tomorrow onwards. So. Let's hope for the best. I really, really hope. rolled in the sand and everything. And then they kind of stopped and just stood there. It was 124 yards. And I'm not willing to take that shot. I'm good to about 100, I'd say. But yeah, they just then, two of them just spooked and the other one kind of stood there and then he took off as well. I don't know, I think the wind might have been a little bit iffy at that stage. So just, you know, it sucks. So it's not even 3 o'clock yet, so we still have like 4.5 hours. Yeah, probably 4 hours and 45 minutes left. It can still definitely happen, so fingers crossed. Speechless. My Garmin said it was 101 yards. It moved probably 4 or 5 yards after I ranged it. It was probably 105, 106. I'll range the spot when I get down there. But yeah, second batch of zebra coming in. I actually thought this was a single one that came in, and then eventually when it got closer to the water, I saw there was more behind it. Super wary. Came in on a string and then all of a sudden stopped and looked at the freaking blind. I don't know why. The wind was good. So I sat here on my knees just trying to figure out where the shot was going to come from so that I could get the video ready. And it stood facing me for 3 minutes and then it turned. And as it turned, I stood up, drew my bow, and then got a range 101. You can see it. In the video, it was kind of, it stopped broadside, and then I remember when I was about to shoot, it walked 4 or 5 steps, and that's when it walked out of the frame. So unfortunately we don't have a shot on film, but yeah, I knew they weren't going to come in, so that was the only opportunity I had. Shot broke perfectly. Shot it with my silverback plus. And initially, I thought I missed it because I didn't hear a twack. The twack only came after they started running. And I remember when Josh Bowmore shot his Tessaby with me at 128 yards, that also happened. So, yeah, shot. When I picked up my binos, I saw at least half of my arrow sticking out on the opposite side. Shot is back, but there was a lot of
red stuff coming out, so I don't know if it's intestines or what, but the arrow is in. Terki is on his way. It's half an hour to 45 minutes. Yeah, between 40 and 45 minutes after the shot. Let's hope we find that mountain zebra. They are by far the most wary animals I've ever hunted. So, I mean, baboons came in and they didn't even know of me, but they, first time and second time, came in, stopped, first went, the first ones went. This one at least gave me a shot, so. Guys, fingers crossed, hopefully we get it.
So guys, I radioed Turkey and we decided to wait until 5 o'clock. Opposite side, probably with like 15 inches, at least half of the arrow. I think the shot is definitely, it's around mid body, probably left and right. The height looked perfect. I think what happened was, it's so difficult without a video because zebra just moved out of the frame when I was basically drawing my bow, so I didn't want to take any chances there. So unfortunately it's not on video for you guys, but it's definitely back. But when it ran away, there was like a hell of a piece hanging out left and right of the zebra, like red. So I don't know, let's see what happens. I did ask Dirkie to bring a rifle with. I really hope it will be a quick kill. Maybe not. It was a ridiculously long shot. But after 6 days, with no luck on these animals, and I mean, I actually thought this one was going to come in. I mean, it just came. And then, all of a sudden, they just looked at the blind. So, it was a massive herd. We'll see what happened. But yeah, fingers crossed. Please. I really hope. It's a successful story. I left that arrow exactly where I should have. Obviously with those long distances, you take a risk, but I did shoot a lot at extreme distances the past couple of days, and especially yesterday I shot over 100 yards, multiple arrows, and got really, really good groupings. Let's see what happens. Fingers crossed. And dang, I really hope that zebra is down already. It will be amazing.
Hartmann's in the movie.
Yeah.
So we're probably 200 yards from where he was when I shot him. There was actually a lot of blood on the trail, and then yards. Let's go and check him out.
Hier achter.
Both of us. It was good. It was back. I wish we had a video just to have an idea of what happened on the shot. Checked it with my binoculars. Now 105 yards. My longest bow cue ever. I don't think I should shoot a shot like that again. But this week calls for dramatic measures. Derki, and now Ben. Thanks, guys. Yes, it's a beautiful animal. We'll set him up for pictures. Super happy that it's a stallion. We'll check him out in a moment. So guys, I'm standing here at the spot where the zebra stood.
105 yards. Just look there. Terke is moving to the vehicle now. There's our blind there at the back. Worked perfectly. The cool thing about it is we built that blind with Derky's dad, so makeshift blind. This was the 7th opportunity, 6 times they busted us. So so happy. Beautiful stallion. I'm gonna go back to him now with my camera and video camera, and then we can get some close-ups. But yeah, insane day. Super thankful for the opportunity to hunt here at Dirk de Boer Safaris in Namibia. Dirk Senior, Dirk Junior, Dirkie, thank you so much for the opportunity. It was truly a special hunt. And this little dam will forever have a special place in my heart. So yeah, can't wait to take some pictures. So sorry I didn't get it on film, guys, but self-filming under those conditions were freaking tough.